Yes. In the last class that we discussed that how to check the statistical summary on the data set that is data frame. Right? So what is the function that there we use? Describe is the function. So by using this describe function that we observe that, okay, the summarization of the data. Whenever if you use the describe on the data frame, okay, just it is going to summarize only on the numerical columns. Only on the numeric columns it is going to summarize. If you want to summarize on the string columns also, then we have to include that object. Okay, so we have to include that object and then we have to check the summarize. Otherwise, if you want to check the summarize on all the columns together, then we have to use include equal to R. Right? And then we started slicing. Okay, how to slice the data, that it is how to subset, how to extract the data. So here by using a position, by using a sequence, that it is begin colon, end colon, end value, begin colon, end colon, step, and also by using particular values. All right. So here we have to take care that at the time of working with this begin, end, step, okay, whether we are going to selecting the data left to right or right to left. What is the step value, whether it is a positive value or a negative value? If it is a positive value, what is the end value? If it is a negative value, what is the end value? So based on that only that we have to work, right? So already we spend a lot of time for accessing the data. So whenever if you want to select the data based on the column names, at that time we have to use LOC, location. Otherwise, whenever if you want to select on the index, at the time ILOC. Right, so like this that we have to work. Now let us observe this. This is the data that we are having. So let us once again run this import numpy and import pandas, and this is the data that we created here. So first we created the data, it is date range after creating this, and then we created the random data. So this is the data that we are having present. This is the data that we are having present, right? So in this data, if I want to select so and so, already that we discussed that how to select, okay, all this. Now, if I want to drop the columns A and D, these two columns that I want to drop, means dropping means, okay, I don't require these two columns. Okay, I want to delete this and then I want to start the analysis on the remaining columns, right? So whenever if you want to drop these columns, then we have to use a function that it is called drop function. What is the function? Drop is the function that we are having, which belongs to the pandas, which belongs to the pandas. Pandas.drop or pd.drop. So, and then whatever the function, whatever the columns that if you want to drop, here I want the columns. Columns equals to, if I want to drop only A, simply that we can write like this. But whenever if you want to drop more than one, so that we have to, okay, represent in the list A comma D that I want to drop. So like this that we have to drop. Okay, once executed, pd dot drop is the function. Here I am going to drop the columns where, okay, the columns is where the columns is A, B. Now let us execute it. Pd dot drop columns. Sorry, not pd. This drop is belongs to pandas only, but we have to mention on which data frame that we are working. Here it is data frame name of the data frame. Here it is data frame name. So present we are working with the DF. This is the data frame, okay, that we are working, which is having these dates and rows and columns. Now let us start working on this DF and then let us execute it. Now it is dropped and then it is, okay, returning only the C and D. Okay, and then it is returning the C and D. See, once again, if I print this DF, here it is having dropped values or entire values. Okay, here it is having the entire values. Okay, again, if you whatever the drop that you've done, again, if you assign into the DF, it is going to update. Otherwise, it is not update. Otherwise, it is not update. So, like this, that we have to work with this, okay, data frame, just how to access and how to drop search. Is it clear? Next, let us keep heading. How to do the concatenation? Concatenation. So concatenation means just combining, right? Adding. So here we are going to concatenate. Here we are going to concatenate the two data frames. So whenever if you want to concatenate the two data frames in pandas, then we have to use a function that is called pd.concat is the function that we are having. pd.concat is the function that we are having. Yes. So if you want to work with the concatenation, okay, here we required two data frames. So let us create the two data frames and then work on that. So now I am creating a data frame A in this data frame. Okay, just I am taking just student name and age data frame so that you can create either list or dictionary or what, however that you require. Just I am taking the dictionary here, name. I'm taking some student names. First values. Next, let us take age. Some set of values. So here I'm giving the index. So even if you give or not, by default it is going to take 0, 1, 2. Right? By default it is going to take 0, 1, 2. Now, B index that I'm giving, pd dot data frame, B data frame that we are creating. Here also I'm going to take some of these values. Name Srinivas, let us take only one. And the age. Some age like 45. Alright. So here I am continuing the index here. Index equals to 3, 4. Right. Now, let us print this A and then let us print this B. Let us execute it. So this is the data that we are having, which belongs to this is A and this is the B data frame. Two data frames that we are having. Now let us start the concatenation on this. So concatenation, what is the function? PD, which belongs to pandas. Concat is the function that we are having. Concat is the function. Here let us concatenate A comma B. So this result that I am going to assign into AB. Now let us print this AB, how it is going to concatenate. Print off this AB and then observe here. So whatever the indexes that we created based on that index, it is work. Now let us observe that it here, it is concatenating all these values. The data which belongs to A and also which is belongs to B. Now these two are concatenated. Okay. So now the final result, it is like this. Final result is like this. Yes. Now, I want to print only the name column. So, how to print it? So, what is the name of the data frame AB? In this, let us give that particular name. Name. let us execute it. So here we are getting only the names. Here we are getting only the names. So like this, that we have to check. Now I want to check that whether Srinivas is available or not. Whether Srinivas is available or not. So if I want to check it, okay, Srinivas is available or not, then we have to compare with the value Srinivas. Whenever if you want to compare the value, then what is the operator that we have to use? Double equal to, right? So now let us compare this Srinivas and then execute it. So if now Srinivas is available or not. So if the Srinivas is available, it returns true. If it is not available, it returns false, right? So two times it is true means two Srinivas it is having. Otherwise, I want to return only the data. I want to return only the data. So whatever the thing that you return here, this is the logic. This is the logic, right? If you want to print this, okay, if you want to print based on this condition, then again you have to write this AB. Here, what we have to do means here AB. Okay, let us keep this entire logic in the bracket. Is it clear that what I am saying? So whatever the thing that we return, that AB of name equal to Srinivas, this is the logic that we return. Just we are checking that Srinivas is available in this name or not. So here it will return the logical value that it is, okay, either it is written true or false. True or false, right? If you want to return the data at the time, you have to keep this entire logic in the, okay, data frame, and then let us work on this. AB. Let us close this and then execute it. So here you'll get that. So this is the data that we are having. Two Srinivas with the age 35. No. In this data, it is having duplicate values or not? Yes. So if you want to delete the duplicate values, then we have to use a function that it is called. Okay. For dropping the columns, what is the function? Drop is the function. Similarly, if you want to drop the duplicates, then we have to use a function that is called drop underscore duplicates is the function that we are having. Drop underscore duplicates is the function that we are having. So by using this drop underscore duplicates, that we are going to, okay, that we are going to drop the duplicates. So on which data frame that we are going to work, the data frame that you have to mention before that, and then on which column that you are going to drop. For example, I am going to drop based on the name column. So you have to specify that name here. Otherwise, whenever if you want to drop based on, okay, two or more columns, at the time you have to mention these columns in the list. Right? Let us drop these values. So here in this example that we observe that Srinivas appears twice in a column name. In the name, it is having twice. In the age also, it is having 35, 35. Let us delete based on the name. So how to delete it? What is the function that we are having? AB is the name of the data frame. AB dot drop underscore duplicates. Drop underscore duplicates. In that, let us mention the name of the column and then execute it. And then execute it. So now whatever the data that we returned, that it is without the duplicates. In the previous, it is having with the duplicate values, that it is Srinivas is appears two times there, twice it is repeated. So now it is, okay, the drop values are, okay, the duplicate values are dropped. Yes? Now, how to sort the values? So here we are having a function that it is called sort is the function that we are having. Sort underscore values is the function. Sort underscore values is the function. By using this sort that we can srecon. So we can combine the two different columns also. But whenever if you want to combine the two different columns, then we have to use a concept that it is called already that we learned in the R programming language. Whenever if you want to combine the two columns, see here, what is the condition that we are following at the combining two rows means two data frames that we are combining based on the row. So whenever if you want to combine the two data frames based on the row, there we have to follow the same columns in the two data frames. We have to follow the same column, the size also, how many columns that it is having. Here also we have to follow the same column. Whatever the names it is having, whatever the data type it is having, same as it is that we have to follow, and then we have to combine the rows. But whenever if you want to combine the columns, okay, already we combined in the R programming language. What is the concept that we are having? Merge is the concept that we are having by using the merge that we combined the columns. So here also by using merge we can combine. Yes, Srikant, that we will discuss already in detail that we discussed in the R programming language. Anyhow, here also we are going to discuss about the merge concept, that combining the two data frames by using columns. Tejaswini, that only that we done now, right? So here we removed the duplicates in the rows. Here we removed the duplicates in the rows. So based on the row, okay, here it is having two Srinivas. So now we removed, and then here it is having only one value. Right? Yes. Now, let us sort the data. If you want to sort, what is the function that we have to use? Sort values is the function which belongs to the data frame. Okay, and then let us mention here on which column that if you want to sort. For example, here I want to sort based on the age. Okay, based on the age that I want to sort here. So whenever if you want to sort, then let us work on this AB dot sort values age. So now let us observe here. Now the data is sorted based on the age. First it is 25, 35, so and so like this. Is it clear? So like this that we have to work. Okay. Otherwise, if you want to change the row names and column names, that you can change by using a function that it is called. Rename is the function that we are having. Rename is the function that we are having. Okay. By using these renames that we can change that. Okay. That we can change the columns. Yes. So what is the difference between merge function and concatenation function? Yes, Varshini, once if you observe here, whenever that we work with the merge function, okay, then we merge, sorry, whenever if you work with the concatenation, then the two data frames are concatenated based on the rows or columns. Based on the rows, it is concatenated, right? For example, in the first data frame, it is having 10 employee details. In the second data frame, it is having some more 10 employee details. Now, if I concatenate this data frame 1 and data frame 2, now the final data frame, it is having 20 employee details. But whenever if you work with the merge, okay? So merge means we are going to combining the two data frames based on the columns. So for example, here in the left side, it is having 10 data frames, and one more data frame 2, it is having 10. Whenever if you merge these two data frames based on any one of the condition that is common column, and then it is going to 10, 10, 20 it is having. 20 it is having. Out of this 10, 10, if it is having one common column, then with one common column remaining 19, it will add. Is it clear? So like this that we have to work. Is it clear? Right. That I will show you that. Okay, already we worked with the concatenation function, right? So that we'll work with the merge. Already we worked this merge function in the R programming language. Okay, the same concept here also, the same data by using the same data set that we will work here. Right? The conditions that we have to follow at the time of concatenation, for example, if you have, okay, four columns in the data frame 1 and two columns in the data frame 2, here it is possible to concatenate the data. Not possible. Why? Because, okay, there it is 4, there here it is 2. It is not possible to combine the rows, okay, in one data frame. At the same time, okay, we are working with the merge. There we have to follow some of the conditions there. Okay, so at the time of merging, there we have to maintain one common column. Minimum one common column we have to maintain. So these are all the conditions that we have to follow at the time of concatenation and merging. Is it clear? Now, let us start working with this rename. So whenever if you want to rename a column in pandas, then we have to use a function rename. So how to follow the syntax here, it is means. So first you have to give the old column, and then you have to mention the new column with colon. So that I will write here, let us observe. Now it is name. In the place of name that I want to take the employee name, EMP name. In the place of age that I want to take, okay, employee age. So at the time that we have to take like this, we are working with the data frame that it is AB. Rename is the function that we are having which belongs to the pandas. Now in this, we are going to work on the columns, right? Columns equals to. Now let us take the dictionary and then let us write the existing name. This is the existing name. In the place of this existing name that I am going to take the employee name. Comma. Next, if you want, see. For example, if you want to change the only one value at the time, we don't require this dictionary representation so and so. But we are changing the two column names. So now in the place of age that I want, employee age. So now let us execute it and then check it. Now it is like this. All right. So like this, that we are having so many functions, not only this, we have so many functions here, the data frame that we will work at the time of doing the analysis by using data frames. So till now that we discussed a lot of data frames. So individually, if you know like this, it will take a lot of time. So let us practice all the data, all the functions that what we worked on the data frame. These are all the functions that frequently we are going to use in the projects. Yes. Now, so descriptive statistics is completed, right? In the last class that we worked with the describe function. So whenever if you use the describe function, pd.describe, there you will get the complete information of the, what is the AB? AB is the data frame, right? So here you'll get the complete information that, how many values count it is getting. What is the minimum value? What is the maximum value? What is the average, that is mean value? 25% means first quantile, 50% means the median, or you can call it is a second quantile. This is the third quantile data. This is the standard deviation. Square root of the variance is called the standard deviation. These are all the information that we will get. Otherwise, on particular column that if you want to check, already it is by default, it is on age only. Why? Because it works only on the numeric. Otherwise, if you want to work on object also, include, here you have to mention object. Let us execute it. So here it is going to work on the object, right? But what it means, it is giving the count that how many values it is having. It is giving that, how many unique names are there, unique values are there. And then, whatever the value it is repeated more top, it is going to get, how many times it is going to frequently repeat it. Right. Next, otherwise, if you want, all the information, not on object or not on numeric value, whenever if you want, all the columns information. So simply that we have to mention all, then you will get the information about all. Is it clear? So already that we worked in the last class about this describe. So whenever if you want to work particularly, for example, I want, let us observe some of the statistical, descriptive statistical functions. Sum is the function. If I use this sum, then you'll get the information that, so sum means just it will concatenate all the names here. At the time of numerical values, it will calculate values. So otherwise, particularly if you want to work on the age, whenever if you want to work on the particular age, let us mention age here. Let us mention the age and then let us work on that. So the sum of all the age, it is 180. Otherwise, I want to count. Count is the function. So these are all the functions which belongs to the descriptive statistics. Just know that we observe the descriptive, right? There itself, you will get all the information. Otherwise, particularly if you want to know, so then we have to use this. Count, total 5. Next time. If I want to find the average, mean. So it is 36. If I want to find the median, median is the function that we are having. So by using median that we can calculate it. Next. whenever if you want to find the mode. Mode means what? What is the mode? Mode means repeated values. Okay, more repeated values it will take. So mode. Whenever if you want to calculate the standard deviation, std is the function that we are having. Okay, so like, okay, all the functions, okay, minimum, min, maximum, max, okay, like this. Is it clear? So like this, that we will check all the descriptive statistics. Now let us observe a merge concept. Already we worked. Now once again, observe in this Python how to work with this merge. What is the use of this merge function? Merge, or also we can call it is a merging or joining. Joining. So whenever if you want to merge, that is join the two data frames based on the columns. At that time we have to use a function that is called merge is the function. There also it is merge. In R also it is merge. Here also it is merge. This merge function is belongs to the pandas pd dot merge. Now, what are the arguments that it is having in this merge function? Means here it is having the arguments that it is, okay, anyhow, if you want to merge the data frames, means minimum that you have to take two data frames. So here I am taking the left data frame and right data frame, left data frame and right data frame, and we are having some of the arguments like how, okay, on, left on, okay, right on, all this. So these are all the different arguments that we are having, okay, how, on, left on, right on, so and so. What is the syntax in merge in R programming language? There it is, merge. Merge. There also you have to take the left hand side table and right hand side table, or simply that we can call that it is x y. X y. After taking this x y, then by. If it is having common column, by using by we are going to work. Otherwise, if it is having different column names, right? So by dot x, by dot y. Next, all dot x comma all dot y sort. So these are all the different arguments that we are having in the merge. The same thing here also, simply some little bit syntax difference that we are having. Remaining everything it is same. Right. Yes, Asra. Now let us start working with this merge. So we are not going to spend more time about this merge. Why? Because already that you know. Okay, already we work in the R. So before working on this merge, that we have to maintain the data frames or not? Yes, first we have to maintain the data frames. So let us create these data frames that I will show you. Let us create the two data frames from your side, and then that will work. Yes, this is one data frame. Let us create the student details data frame, and then let us create the course details data frame, and then let us start working with the merge concept. So if you have data with you, and then only it is possible to work. Otherwise, okay, here it is not possible. And then here in at the time of joining also, see, joining is nothing but, okay, in database management system subject we are having joining concept. How to join the two data, okay, two tables. The same here also we are going to, okay, merging these two data frames. So let us create the student details. Once if you create the student details, then it is okay, then we can run work on that. So simply let us take it, student details equal to pd dot data frame. In this, let us take the, okay, that is your wish. Okay, you can create by using dictionary. Otherwise, if you want to create by using the list with giving the column names, you can create it. So create all these values. Once again, connect with the same link.